We're going to press car. All right, follow me.
Let's go. Congrats.
Reporting.
You look great. You got down.
Get in there.
Excuse me.
We're coming in.
Hey, Zach, back recording.
Sorry, I'm gonna slide down on the floor. Sorry. Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
All right, who's got the first question?
Hey, what's up, bro?
Josh. Hey, Nate. Josh Gross over here with the Orange County Register. Nate. 5 years ago, you made this fight happen. You made it out of thin air. You call that George. Could you have imagined that it would lead to something like this, something this big? Was that in your head at all?
Yeah, I figured whatever I was gonna do next was gonna be big back then too. And nobody's doing much, or knows I'm doing anything much. So, I like motherfuckers who can get it popping. And they should recognize that too. Do the same.
Nate, right here. Simon Simano with MMA Junkie. You walk away from this fight with a majority victory. Is it a satisfying victory?
Yeah, as far as boxing goes and that, and what was the round count? What was the
7-3.
7-3, yeah, that's cool. But
a little bit more that
with him, it should have been a real fight. But I'm happy I got the opportunity to fight somebody who I like a real fight. So it was good to have an opponent. We had something to fucking fight for.
What would be your assessment of the fight? Because Jorge came in here and said that you put pressure with a lot of volume, but you never really hurt him, and that he landed the bigger shots in the fight. Is that accurate to you, or what do you think of
it? I think he threw the harder shots and was trying to kill, but couldn't get no jobs done. I never really got hurt. He made it with a couple of things there. Like, all right, motherfucker, I'm not gonna let you do that again. But it was shorter round. I think we could have done a lot more damage, but it was 10 rounds, so I treated it like that.
Now that it's tied 1-1 between you guys and he's got the victory from 5 years ago, that felt a little, you know, I know you felt a little burned by it, that it was taken from you from the doctors. This fight ends in a majority decision. Does it feel like this chapter of your career is closed, or would you like to run a trilogy with Jorge?
That's a whole nother situation for later. I think we're 1-0 on each other. He got a win in MMA, and I gotta fight. I gotta win in boxing, so who knows what's gonna happen next with him, but at some point, something.
And in the ring, you got on the mic, and the very first thing you did was you called out Jake Paul. Can we act, you know, it's a fight that's been talked about.
Just off the top of my head, I would like to whip his ass. I would like to get a win against Leon Edwards, who's the best fighter in the world right now at 170. And, I think that's what something major. Who's actually gonna bring something that I could take and put in a credential box? That's what I'm going for. I'm not playing for no fucking fun fights, because that shouldn't be fun.
Last thing for me, just to follow up, then the fact that the Jake Paul fight has been talked about for the last 2+ years, it seems you guys have gone back and forth with each other on social media. You know, you guys have gotten into it before. How realistic can we see a fight between you guys, whether that's boxing or an MMA?
It's fucking pretty realistic, as far as I'm concerned. That's the only thing I got in my head is whoever thinks they're fucking tight. could get their ass whooped.
Name right here. I asked Chris this question as well. They released the payment before the fights tonight, and a lot of the members of Team Diaz were getting paid pretty well. So how does that feel to see your team getting paid well and the team being brought up together? And do you think that more people in combat sports should look out for their team the way that you do?
First and foremost, shout out to my boy right there with the Nelk Boys. Happy Dad, and I see you consistent with this shit. That's tight. And that everybody who's with me is fucking doing what I do, and they deserve the world. So, and a lot of other fighters probably in a similar situation. So it's up to them if they gonna get it, because we're gonna get it, and that's the plan. And I plan on all these guys that came with me to go a lot farther than they even fucking kicked off as. Like, they're gonna fucking blow up to the max if they keep their eyes on, because these are the guys that'll take the war with me.
And then I just wanted to ask about the tribute to Mike Tyson, the B-Real that you walked out with. Just what was the thoughts behind it?
That's what this whole shit is all about. And come in here and fucking whip ass, and if you got the fucking mics and the cameras on you, you tell them what was real. And when I saw Mike Tyson walk out like that, that's what this whole shit's about.
Hey Nate, Carlo Pruzzo, Carlo Pruzzo MMA. The crowd was going absolutely electric tonight. That place was nuts. Do you enjoy getting to fight in front of your home state crowd?
Yeah, I love it. I love that. I know where everything's at here. I know a bunch of people here. And this is the best state and the best country in the world. So why would I not want to be here?
Last question. Our fight day is a little different without...